Yo.
Today we're going razor clamming.
I am headed to Seaside, Oregon to meet up with my little cousins, Sky and Tyson. We're going on a 5-day road trip from here to Washington. We do some outdoor activities, exploring, shopping, and most importantly, eating good food. This is day 1 and 2.
What's
up? Tyson, you're about to be taller than me. Tyson, what you want to do when you grow up?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Be the biggest mutt.
Oh, you're going to try to do a... Oh, that's a nice one. Show me how you grab it. Show me how you grab it.
Oh, wait, oh, like this?
I'm holding a gun.
It's hard. Beast in action.
Well, I saw him just do it regular. I don't know what I'm doing.
Ooh, look at that beast.
This is beautiful. No, you have to...
With my niggas in my red Mercedes. Attitude like fuck you pay me. Roll it deeper than
go.
The devil we go out. If the ladies show up then we show out.
This shit so clean, I put that on my life. Red Mercedes green, it's a different type.
Yeah, just step on him.
3, 2, 1, go.
Going out to the side to do it.
That's pretty strong.
It's probably as strong as Hannah.
We'll just hang on right here.
Come on, Sky. Don't let this happen.
Turn your wrist,
your wrist. No. Go. Push, push. Keep pushing, keep pushing.
Oh, you are pretty strong, Tyson.
Tell me what we're doing today.
Yo.
Today we're going razor clams.
So we have never caught razor clams before. We're looking for holes in the sand that the clams make by shooting water up. This picture shows the 3 different types of holes we're supposed to find.
So this dimple is what you're looking for. We got all these holes.
I don't know what it was, but we pulled every single one of these holes. And we didn't find a single clam.
That thing was solid.
Did you try that one again?
Shake it, yeah. Then it'll get really deep.
It was a lot of work. Every single pull is like a leg workout.
Oh, strong man!
No way.
Dang.
Oh, here, I found one.
You did?
Oh, it's a baby one. That's the
one. Oh, nice. Dang. Baby razor clam.
We started to get a few here and there, but it wasn't until we went out to the sandbar that we actually started catching a lot of them.
Deadlift. Need one more. No, it was a false one.
Oh, I felt something.
Oh, I just did. Yeah, what? one more. Or I'll just grab it.
You got it!
I know it looked sunny, but it was really cold out on the beach. We had some Vietnamese porridge to warm up, and Sky was able to take back the throne for strongest brother. Now it was time to explore the city.
No, you call her a 7. We asked you to rate her. You rated her a 7.
Call it a bit truthfully. -4.
This place was filled with thrift shops and souvenir stores. The first store had workwear and antiques. It was really cool, but it was way too pricey for me. As we're walking down the strip, there's so many stores we started to be selective with where we went. Then we checked the arcade for Dance Dance Revolution, but sadly, they didn't have it.
Yeah.
We kept walking to a bunch of random shops until we found something that caught our eye. Pokemon. And these are 2 of my favorites.
Anime girls? Let me pull one.
Ooh, let me see the next one. Let me check out all these cards actually. How much is it? No, I'm just kidding.
I'm glad you guys wanted to go to San Francisco.
Apparently these shoes have some connection with Wu-Tang, all of them. I have never seen anything like this or this one. Yeah, I've never seen these ones at all. Why did I not choose to live in Seaside? Why did I choose Eugene?
The girls were talking about this place that sells elephant ears, and they were literally hyping it up the whole time we're walking. And of course I love food, so we had to check it out. It starts as some pizza looking dough, then they fry it, coat it with a hefty brush of butter, and topped it with cinnamon sugar. I'm looking at this like it's the most unhealthy dessert I've ever seen. So you know we had to hit y'all with a peaked review.
Tell me how it is.
It's not as good as I remember.
Not as good as you remember.
Let's try this elephant ear. This is what it's doing. Now, the first thing off the bat, this thing is buttery. This joint is booty. Don't ever come back.
I would give it a 3 out of 10. I would not recommend this to anyone. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. The next spot we're headed is this hidden candy shop called Candyman.
Step right on up to the wheel of fortune line. 1, 2, or 3, and win something free. Give it a whirl. Good spin. Oh, good try. There's some triple berry for you. Good try, there's some cotton candy for you. Oh, so close, there's some birthday cake for you.
Thank you.
Good. Oh, good try, there's some blueberry for you.
Right in line.
Good. Oh, good try, there's some strawberries and cream for you. Good. Oh, good try, there's some blueberry for you. Good.
That is 50 RPM.
We've got a winner! And you've won an old-fashioned candy stick. Go ahead and write your name and where you're from there.
How about you tell us a little bit about yourself?
You got one of those candy sticks for yourself.
Which one? Cherry cola. I feel like that might be kind of good. Or actually, we're getting passion fruit.
That's enough.
Show me what you got.
Low juice. You gotta do it quick. Bug.
No, walk in front of the camera. Casey Neistat it, obviously.
After a full day of shopping, we were ready to hit the beach again, and we came up with this idea to just dig a huge hole for a fire pit later on. Similar to my other video. We came back and Chef Linda started whipping it up in the kitchen. I was working on my meatball skills. These are just some shrimp meatballs for a soup. We were witnessing her make 6 dishes simultaneously. She fried some sausage, made Nook Mum boiled eggs, steamed cabbage, soup with the shrimp meatballs, a shrimp omelet, a grouper steak, caramelized pork ribs, and she poached the razor clams with lemongrass and chilies.
They aren't cooking all of the clams right now, so I'm gonna go upstairs and try to steal one. Where are they? We got it. We run it.
Watching that bad boy.
Yeah.
And the key to razor clams is breaking it down and eating it piece by piece.
This is the skirt. It gets trimmed off that belly portion right there.
Tastes kind of like an oyster. As requested by Lawan, here is a raw razor clam. Broke it down, we got the skirt.
So we got skirt.
I think this part is gonna be the best part.
There's no way I'm eating that.
Happy birthday
to you.
Finally, we made it out to the beach with supplies in hand. A chicken breast, razor clams, bacon, and eggs. We also found this flat rock earlier that we tried to preheat to cook everything on.
No sizzle at all.
It's always fun cooking over an open fire, and it adds this great smoky flavor to everything. I think my cousins really enjoyed it.
Now that thing cooked, it might be chewy, but it's cooked.
Yep,
yeah, good?
Good?
Ah!
It's so bad. I'm sorry, guys.
No, we can't do this.
Oh! We are in business!
And that is it. That's gonna be done in 2 seconds now.
Oh, that's not you guys.
No, wait, it's still good.
A little bit more.
A little bit.
That's got a touch of the nature on it. Put it on the clam. Yeah, just leave it right there for now.
Rinse it off.
Oh my god.
That is as most cancerous chicken breast.
Got our clams, buddy.
Ah!
I'm not gonna drop this one. I'm actually gonna make sure I don't drop this one. Close enough. At least you got one.
Greedy, isn't it?
You don't eat the goo?
Mm-hmm. Delicious. Delectable and kind of crunchy from the sand, you know?
Okay.
I don't think you like that one.
Hey, why did it fart? Elena? Elena? That was crazy.
Eat it.
That is so full of sand.
We put a whole egg in there to cook it, but we ended up forgetting about it and buried it when we were putting out the fire. This was really one of my best vacations ever, and I'm really glad you guys got to see this. Next video, we're going to the Tillamook Cheese Factory, eating pho, exploring Beaverton, Oregon. So subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching.